great I am.
You are the great I am.
Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You reign over all the land.
You reign over all the land.
Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You are my Lord and King.
You are my Lord and King.
Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You reign over everything.
You reign over everything.
Say mighty.
Mighty.
Holy.
Holy.
Everybody sing higher and higher. Why don't you lift up the name of Jesus higher? Lift it up higher. Oh, because he's worthy. Woo. I don't know, man. I'm just like, I don't know. You know, I thought I was at the well. I feel like I'm at a white church I've been at in Indiana for about a week now. I'm going to tell y'all there's something about when you come to the well. You know what I'm saying? The woman at the well found that out before we ever even started this church. Because there's living water that flows. So I don't know if there's anybody around here that's had an encounter with the one whose eyes burn like fire. But I want to know, can you shout tonight and say, somebody give them a shout of praise. Is there anybody free in the building tonight? Is there anybody free in the building? Come on, if you're free, I want you to put your hands together. Come on, clap. Listen, you came to set the captive free. Came to bring us liberty. My sin and my rejection, but your blood and my acceptance. Now I'm alive to bring you praise. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Come on, let me hear you say it.
Where the Spirit
empowers me to wear my pain and my oppression, but your blood and my acceptance. Now I'm alive to bring you praise.
Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom.
Everybody say,
where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom.
Every chain is broken
through you, Jesus.
Where the Spirit
of the Lord is, there is freedom.
Right here, I love this line. Every chain was broken. Woo, in 33 AD, not in 2015. Through you, Jesus. Woo, I'm declaring to you tonight, it's where the Spirit of the Lord, there is freedom. Say,
beautiful love, you are my king.
You're all I need. The one who carried the cross carries me. I'm gonna need you to think about what you're singing tonight. Come on, declare it. Tell him you're everything. Tell the Lord.
You're everything.
Come on, let him know from your heart. You're all I need.
You're all I need.
Now here's your promise tonight. Lifted high, say, you're all I want,
you're all I need, you're everything, you're everything,
oh God,
you're all I want, you're all I need, you're everything.
love this. You bring your kingdom and stand by. Come on, sing it, Agape. The giver, more than I need, more than. Tell him, Father, you're everything. Father, you're. That's precious. That's precious. Say, there's no one like you. There is no one like you, Lord, anymore. I just love to sing it to the Lord like this.
Come on, lift your hands unto the Lord. Oh, we want to reverence you tonight, Jesus. Oh, we want to tell you how much we love you tonight, Jesus.
There is no
open your mouth unto the Lord. Come on, with the fruit of your lips, tell him that you love him. Tell him that you adore him. Tell him you want to worship him. Tell the Lord he's great. Tell the Lord he's mighty. Yeah, your love is unsearchable, Jesus. There's no one like you. There's no one like you. I want to love you. I want to praise you. I want to serve you. You're my everything, God. There's no one like you. If you believe there's no one like the God, there's no one like the God I serve. There's no one like the God.
Bow down in your presence.
It's like a sweet smell and savor, Jesus. Hey, mama. It's a sweet savor.
Saying that some of you saying the struggle is real. The struggle is real. It's real. But when you're in God, He can deal with it. And when He deals with it, He can reveal to you what your issue is. I'm going to ask the prayer intercessors to come forth tonight, right now, in the name of Jesus. Come down there in the house. Some of you are struggling for real. Oh God, you saying, God, I'm ready to give up. Oh God, I can't make it. This is a God interrupted the service for you tonight. Yeah, God. Oh God, we thank you for raining on us. See, He's raining on us tonight. Oh God, I thank you for raining on us. Yes. Yeah.
See His glory.
If you need prayer for your husbands, you come up here.
Yeah. Something's moving.
Something's moving.
Something's changing.
Something's changing.
See the glory.
Hey, Jesus. That's right.
Something's moving.
Oh, God.
Something's changing.
Yeah, yeah.
See the glory.
Somebody's
right
been
now,
having throat
something's
issues.
Something's shifting.
God is going to restore
see
your throat
glory.
Again. Healing for your voice. Healing for your voice.
Something's shifting.
Yeah.
Something lifted,
yeah.
See the glory.
Yeah,
see the
yeah. massive. Stomach problems. God is going to restore you and heal you tonight. God shifted this service just for you tonight. It's about you tonight. God said, I'm concerned about you. That's why he's moving and shifting and lifting things tonight. Yeah, God. Oh, some of you say, God, who's going to look out for me? God said, I'm looking out for you right now. I'm looking out for you now. You're covered. You're covered. You're covered. You're covered. Yeah, yeah. You find two or three people and begin to hug them and say, something's shifting. Shifting. Something's moving.
It's lifting.
Something's shifting in my life. Oh. Come on, go to people. I'm telling you. Telling you.
Oh, it's
shifting. It's moving.
It's
oh, God. Something. We're going to see the glory.
We're
going to see the glory. Going to see the glory. Oh, God. That's right. Hug them. Of the Lord in here. How many of you feel refreshed tonight? How many of you feel restored tonight? God is here for you tonight. The miracle is here for you tonight. Just believe it and receive it. Somebody shout glory. Woo! Hallelujah, hallelujah to Jesus. I don't know about you, but I feel the presence of God. When God wraps himself around you, there's nothing else that you can do. It's no food, it's nothing in your house that'll make you comfortable, but like the love of God. Somebody say, I'm so glad he loved me. I'm so glad he didn't give up on me. I'm so glad I can move because of him. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. This is a holy night.
Yeah.
This is a righteous night. God is doing some things now in the atmosphere. And let me tell you something, I'm getting ready. Not just getting ready, I'm staying ready. Ah, there's a difference. There's a difference than getting ready than staying ready. But we reverence God on tonight. We reverence him. He's the holy one. He's the righteous one. That's why I say he's my everything. He's my everything. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for being here tonight. You're lovable. You're accountable. Oh, you're our King. You're our Lord. God, you're the wonderful counselor. You're the Prince of Peace. God, we can't move without you. God, we can't even see without you. We can't even speak without you, Jesus. God, I thank you, Father God, for your word that comes forth tonight, Father God. That it comes out, Father God, like you desired for it to come out tonight, Father God. I thank you that strongholds will be broken tonight, Father God. The brokenhearted will be mended tonight, Father God. I thank you that you will give the minstrels a new song tonight. God, I thank you, Father God, that you're shifting, you're lifting. God, you're doing new things tonight, God. God, we're ready for the new. God, we're ready for the new, God. Hey, God. And God, we bless your name for it because you're all powerful. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, good evening. Sometimes when you get foggy, when you get out of the worship, you know, it's good to worship God. It's good to stay in that place all the time. Not some of the time, but all the time, because God is so refreshing. That's what I put on. I think I put on my Facebook and said, when you need strength, that's when you get spend time with God. That's for somebody tonight. You say, God, I need some strength. I need some joy. I need some peace. I need some hope. I don't know what to do. He said, just spend time with me and release it. Release it. Stop trying to carry it yourselves. He said, I got you covered. No matter what happens in the world, no matter what happens in your home, the difficult times, the challenges that you may see, say, my God, I don't know, my children, my job, my marriage, this, that, you fill in the blank. But God said he has you covered. You just keep building your altars, keep building your altars, and you'll see God do a new thing, amen? Amen. If you have your Bibles, please open them. Pastor is on his way. He told me that we were supposed to tag team tonight. I said, thank you for telling me, my Jesus. He said, I'm going to tag with you on the end. I said, okay, what? You're the man of the house. I'll flow with you. I try to be a good wife. Amen. How many try to be a good wife? Amen. We try to. I mean, I tell you, I'm trying every day. Every day. I'm telling you, my God. Do we have any first-time guests tonight? I'm sorry. Do we have any first-time guests? Okay, we're all family. Again, nobody didn't bring any chicken tonight. Because I am hungry, my Jesus. Amen. Hungry for the word, too. Amen. Turn your Bibles to 2 Chronicles, the 29th verse. Amen. Because there is a word for you tonight. There is a word for you. Somebody say sound check. Check your ears, honey. Check your ears, my God, because God wants to speak to you. Some of you have been in dry places. I mean, very dry. I mean, it's some of you, it's very difficult for you because you've never been in this place. But this is not the time to run from God. This is the time to run towards God. Even when you don't see your promise. Even when you don't feel your promise. Know that God has you covered. Whatever God said, that settles it. Don't ever let anybody distract you from loving God. Co-workers, no. Family, no. That's why you have to stay planted in the word of God. You got to keep watering that seed. Because I see some of you crying at night, even some of you online, very depressed. But God's going to bring you up and out of this thing. You thought because he left you, you couldn't make it. Oh, you just beginning a new chapter. Somebody say, I thought that was the end of the story. But the story is just beginning. Because sometimes in your life when you feel like everything is giving up, you feel like giving up and everything, you don't know where to go. You feel like you don't even have a word in your belly. You're home, you're depressed, you're alone, and you're doing this and doing that. God said, look, that ain't the end of the story. That's the making of a victory. Let your obstacle become your victory. Don't let the enemy shut you down. You shut the enemy down with your praise. You shut the enemy down with your mouth. You shut the enemy down with your worship. Because that's something that he doesn't like. And he knows that you're mowing. Anytime you stand in one place and you feel like you're alone, then he starts talking to you. He starts talking to you, telling you what you can't do. That's what we have a problem with. You know what? We always think not what we can do. We always have a problem with what we can't do. God said, I can, you can do all things through Christ that strengthens you. So this is a season not to stand up to the devil. It's always a season to stand up to the devil. Some of you have been crouching over. God said, no, I need you standing up in this time. I need you standing in for your family. I need you standing in. Well, God, I don't know who's going to take care of me. He said, I got you covered. Amen. Jeremiah preached the gospel for 40 years and nobody repented. He didn't stop. My gosh. And we go and witness to one person, they don't get saved, and we put our head down. Some plant, some water. Long as you get the seed out there, you share the good news. You do what God tells you to do. That's what it's all about. You're not going to stop the good news on the inside of me. That's what we have social media for, ladies and gentlemen. Share the good news. Let God be the host of your post. And watch God move. Amen. Turn to 2 Corinthians, the 29th verse. My God, God does have a word for you tonight. He changes things around all the time. My God. But I love him for that. That lets you know that you trust him. Amen. 2 Corinthians, the 29th verse, the 29th chapter, and the 36th verse. It says, and Hezekiah rejoiced, and all the people that God had prepared. And Hezekiah rejoiced, and all the people that God had prepared, the people, for the thing was done. Everybody say it. Oh, y'all didn't say that loud enough. The thing was done. Y'all didn't sing, y'all didn't say that like you really mean it. Said the thing was done what? That's what I'm talking about. Suddenly, so if I can use for a title or a theme tonight, hold up, wait a minute. I feel a suddenly on the way. Look at your neighbor and say, hold up, wait a minute. I feel a suddenly on the way. See, when you get the suddenly in your spirit, things begin to change. You know when it's shifting. You know when things are changing in your lives. You're not going to let anybody get you off track. See, suddenly comes unexpectedly. See, you don't know what things are going through. You don't know. See, a suddenly came. You know what? Even today, I think Fontella emailed me today. See, I was at home because the kids weren't feeling well today. I said, God, but I got to keep going. I got to be a mama, and then I got to be a mama here, too. Because I got to keep going. And she called, she said, well, Pastor, somebody saw your name, look you up in It Takes a Church, and they want you to do an audition for, I guess, a reality show or something. Somebody say, suddenly. Not saying that I'm going to do it, but they came and found my name. Amen. So they were with Fox on TV. I said, okay, God, he said, that's how quick I'm going to turn this thing around in your life. And the ones that believe it. See, some of you got bubbles on your head and say, oh my God, that's just a cliche and that's what. But when I believe it, God, my God, that's when it happens. See, when you get that thing in your hand, when you get that marriage, that children, that boys, whatever you believe in God for, God said he was going to do a suddenly. And when you believe that in your spirit, it happens. Suddenly, God is going to turn things around in your marriage. Suddenly, God is going to turn things around in your mind. Some of you are playing mind games tonight, my God. You're going back and forth. God said, I need you stable in the word of God. How dare can you say, you do this, God? Is there anything? God Almighty. Woo, that leaped in my belly. Is there anything too hard for God? Somebody say no. The God that owns the universe, the God that owns everything, That's why when my suddenly come, I'm telling you, while you sitting there looking and you act like you don't know, I'm going to be going with my suddenly. Because whether you realize it or not, there's a shifting in this house. Even the suddenly, I think even for connections, you know, we invited Pastor Joanne Rosario. And then I think she was on Periscope and she said, I just found out that I'm pregnant. I said, it was just like Mary and Elizabeth with the babies leaped when she said it. Because God said, you know what? I've changed the whole thing around. She's coming here with a double blessing. Because what's in her belly is blessed. She said, I had a miscarriage, but God blessed me with a baby. Some of you have been trying to get pregnant. Some of you saying, God, I don't know why. Why am I going through this? That means God is getting ready to do a suddenly. Then I go on Jewel Tankers, one of her daughters or whatever. She just had a baby, my God. God said connections is going to be a birthing room. You can think it's the same if you want to. But I'm not going to miss it. And I'm not going to miss what God has for me. Because God is dropping suddenlies all around us. And if you're not positioned, and if you're not careful, you will miss it. Keep thinking this job is just a regular job. It is not a regular job. Just thinking you're a housewife, and you're just thinking that's right. It ain't regular, honey. God is changing things around. He's getting ready to do a suddenly. Well, I want to give you a history of that. This is what's happening. Hezekiah reopens the temple. Let me give you some history. Hezekiah, I'm going to give it to you tonight, too. Tucking your toes, I'm telling you. It's a good word. Hezekiah, daddy, Ahaz, you know, he was a king that turned against God. He really turned against God. And you know what? He began to do things. He began to turn against God, you know, do things, different things. And God was angry with Ahaz. That what he did was, he was thinking that, you know, even when, Demarcus, when they killed him, he said, well, let me handle their gods. Let me try their gods. If that little god helped him, that little god may help me. So he said, you know, let me check those gods. Then he went to the temple. Now, this is the crazy thing today. I would say, my Jesus. He went to the temple and got all the valuable resources that was in there and went out there and put them in the streets and everywhere and said, look, I'm going to make them as little gods. I'm going to be the man because it's all about me. But when his son Hezekiah came up, he said, I'm getting ready to change the agenda. Because his daddy had locked the doors, turn off the lights in the temple. Didn't let anybody go in the temple. I mean, everything closed. Just like you turn off the lights in here, the doors were closed. Hezekiah, I said, because I'm reigning. The first thing he did in the first month, and the first day he said, I'm going to repair the doors. I'm going to open the doors. Why? Why are doors so important? Because that's your access. What he shut caused him to miss his suddenly. What Hezekiah opened caused him to get his suddenly. And he began to open up the doors. He said, you know what? I want to open up the doors now. I want to repair. And when you repair, that means you're setting things in order. He said, my ancestors messed up before God. They did this and they did that. That's why our wives and different things are in slavery. Isn't that something? The choices that we make can affect our families, can affect us suddenly. Some choices that we make in life, we say, oh my God, I want the suddenly, but then we go the opposite way. And God said, I want you to do something different. I'm telling you, this year in this hour, whatever God tells you to do, do it. Do it. Even Sunday, God said, I want you to give $180. I said, my Jesus, God, we'll do it. Whatever you tell me to do. He said, because you're getting ready to do it, $180. I'm getting ready to turn some things the opposite way. The things that you don't think is going to happen, it's coming a new way. That's why the phone call, that's why things are coming. When you trust God, When you believe God, that's what makes you authentic. When you pray when others are sleeping. When you're worshiping when everybody's doing everything else. That's why I said you make it a habitation. So Hezekiah, he said, no, I want to open the doors. I want to repair. Not only open the doors, I want to repair. Oh my gosh. I want to repair. I want to get the doors right. Because the temple's been closed down. They done closed. They turn off the lights on the porch. There's no candles in there. Everything shut down. The altars, everything shut down. But I'm getting ready to open this thing. Because God, I want to make a covenant with God. See, when the new king came along, Hezekiah was a good king. He loved God. He loved the things of God. He wanted to do what's right. That's what I tell you, do what's right all the time. Not some of the time. You good when you can do something right when nobody's looking at you, watching you. That's what God is. And you know God is watching you. But we don't think like that. So Hezekiah said, I want to prepare. I want to open up the door. I want to do the things right. And you know what he said? I want to open it up to the public. Because they had gone through a thing. The daddy was distressed. The daddy was, his daddy was, and his daddy died. That's why he took over. Isn't that something? How his daddy was corrupt, but God still has a seed. That's why you're planting your children, because you don't know how you might turn out, so your children come up. Come on here. Doing the right thing. So Hezekiah, you know what he did? He said, you know what? I want to open the doors. I want to repair. He said, but when I open it, first thing I'm called, he brought the priest and the Levites. That's the first two groups he called. He said, the priest and the Levites, come on up. That's what he did. He said, because if this house is going to be set in order, because when you come in the house, what do you see first standing up here? The worship. The worship's got to be tight. The worship has got to be real. The worship has got to be heartful. The worship has got to be genuine. I can't have fake stuff, authentic stuff at the beginning, at the front. He said, it's got to be right. So he told the Levites, he said, I want you to stop dragging your feet. I want you to get in here in the house of the Lord. And I want you to do what's right. I know what my dad has done, but I want you to do what's right. That's why I call you. Come on, priests, come on. It's time to rise up. If your minister, it's time to rise up. Get into your word of God. Stand on the word of God every day, every night. That's what he was calling. He said, there's been a shift. There's been a change in this place. Because when he opened the doors, he said, I got to repair. But then when I repair, I've got to call the right people. My God, my God. See, when you put the wrong people in the place, my God, wrong things start happening. Wrong things start happening. See, you can't develop anybody with the wrong things. See, they get that spirit in them. That's why you cannot get a suddenly with the wrong things in your life. That's why the word repair means the act of putting something in working order. See, Hezekiah's father, what he did, he nailed and boarded the door. He nailed it. And sometimes God will show me, he said, sometimes the doors in your lives, that's what you're doing. You have bolted the doors in your life. You say, God, I have given up on you. And God said, it's time to reopen the temple. It's time to get back into your worship. It's time to get back on your face before God. It's time to get into his presence now. That's what he wants you to do. So Hezekiah, my God, he assembled the priests and the Levites in the courts on the east side. He said, listen, consecrate yourselves. That was, he said, set yourself apart. Don't be like the crowd. Don't be like everybody that's in. Oh, God, I got to be like the crowd. My God, God is looking for individuals in the crowd. That's what he's looking for. I think sometimes we try to hook up and we say, oh, God, I got this group and I got this group. God said, what about me? Consecrate yourselves. He said, our ancestors have turned from this house. He boarded up the doors. He turned off the lights. He did different things. And God said, I'm not pleased with that. So he made the wrong choices. And then when he got in there, let's go to this verse. I'm sorry. He got in there. Let's go to verse 3. He said, in the first year reign, the first month, opened the doors of the house of the Lord and repaired them. And he brought the priests, you see it for yourself, and the Levites, and he gathered them together on the east side and said unto them, hear me, Ye Levites, sanctify now, not later. My God. Sometimes we try to wait later. Sanctify yourselves now. Sanctify the house of God, God of your fathers, and carry forth the filthiness out of the holy place. That means they were doing some things in there. He said, you got to get it out. For our fathers have trespassed and done that which is evil in the sight of the Lord. That's what he did. And then read verse 7. It says, also they have shut the doors of the porch. My God. What did it say? Put out the lamps. They have burned incense, nor burnt offerings in the holy place. Wherefore the wrath of the Judah and Jerusalem, and he had delivered them to trouble, astonished them to hissing to see their eyes. I want you to go to verse 20. It says, then Hezekiah the king rose and gathered the rulers of the city. My God. Because he knew the government needed to be in there. My Jesus. So he went up to the house of the Lord, and he said, they brought seven bullocks and seven rams. And it goes on and on and on. So that means when they opened the house of the God, they brought something. Isn't that something? When we come to the house of God, I know we don't have to give anything, but you always bring something to the house of the God, to the house of the Lord. You bring something to say, you appreciate it, God. I adore you. I love you. It says it brought something to the house of the God, house of God in verse 25. I'm sorry. And he set the Levites in the house with cymbals. My God. That's what he did. He set the Levites in the house with cymbals. That means before you're suddenly, a sound must come forth. Before you're suddenly, it has to be a right sound, not a distorted sound. So he said, get your instruments ready. That means not just the instruments that you're playing, but the instrument that's in your heart. That's why I tell the Levites up here, even the worship leaders, why don't you worship at home? Get it in your belly. Not just when you come up here. God, I know that I wish I could play the keyboard. I wish I could play the guitar. I wish I could play the drums. I'll be too wild then if I could play all those instruments. But it's something when you get in a place by yourself and you begin to worship God. You say, God, this is the song of the week. Let me get it in my spirit. Let me get it in my belly because I know something is going to happen. Let me see how the atmosphere is. And before you know it, God will have you playing keys that you never played before. God will have healing come over you like never before. Next thing you know, you're playing and people been healed. People have been delivered. That's why he said the worship has got to be right. So when he told everybody to bring the offering, he said, bring them. This is all for Israel. I'm telling you to bring everything. Thank you. He said, bring the offering, bring everything. So he sacrificed everything. He said, okay, I need the praise and worship to get up singing. I need them shout. They were celebrating. And after a while, he said, everything is okay. He said, it's right now. He said, everything is good. He said, now, he said, I want y'all to continue to bring. And when you read down on further, it was an overflow. It was an overflow because the Levites and the priests were in charge. But guess what? They didn't have enough priests in the house. The Levites were more prepared than the priests. The priests didn't have enough, but the Levites was already stored up. That means even the ministers, you have to be ready for the overflow. God said when they begin to celebrate, when they begin to worship, when they begin to do things, because he called two, and this is for somebody now, he called two groups, the priests and the Levites. There was so much stuff that they were bringing. Said everybody came in the house bringing a Thanksgiving gift, a Thanksgiving offering. Everybody in the congregation. So he called the priests and said, come on. They said, we don't have enough. The Levites ran up and said, we got you. They were lined up. They were ready. It's something when you get ready for your suddenly. People look at you and say, how in the world did they get blessed like this? How in the world did they get that check? How in the world did God open those doors? Somebody said, it's behind the scenes. See, God is not looking for celebrities in heaven. He's looking for servants. When you begin to serve in the house of God, my God, doors will be open for you. Doors will open for you like never before. Where was I serving in the house of God when they called? They found me in the house of God serving. Because it's going to take a church to move the things in the thing in this world. And there's something about when you start serving, my God. Even when you're tired. Even when you say, God, my God, I can't even get out that soprano note. My God, I done worked all day. My God, I got this work stank on me. I just don't feel like it. But then when you think about the one who gives you life, when you think about the one that gives you hope, the one that gives you endurance, when you thought about giving up on your life last year, when you thought about just saying, God, I throw my hands up. I don't know what to do. I don't have no money. I'm jacked up or whatever. And God said, come on. I'm the one that's got you covered. And that's what Hezekiah did in the house. He said, now I want us to worship. He said, I want you to worship. He said, I don't want you to get in pride. I want you to worship. And immediately when they begin to worship, guess what? God did a suddenly right then. Some of you are waiting on your suddenly, but you ain't worshiped. You worship here, but you ain't worship home. You worship here, but you ain't worship on your lunch break. You worship here, but you ain't even worship in your backyard. You got some steaks out there. That's a good time to worship when you got a ribeye on the steak, when you cook it. I say, oh God, I thank you that I got food to eat tonight. I remember when I didn't have food. I remember when I didn't have the money. I remember when I was going to different coats and different pants in my house trying to find change. But God, you made a way. That's why I say it could have been the other way. But then God kept me. That's what's going to keep you moving is your worship. That's what makes you authentic. Anybody can praise God. We can praise God, but when you start worshiping, woo, something happens. Something begins to turn in your belly. You begin to think about how good God is. You begin to think about His grace. When you were out there doing your mess, when you were right in your mess, God could have said, I'm going to snatch you up. But He said, I got you covered. Hey, God. While you were in sin, God said, that's mine. Don't you touch him. Don't you touch him. And you laying up there, you doing your business and you doing whatever. And God said, uh-huh. When she get up, guess what? I'm still going to cover. You still got to go through the consequences. But when God's hand is on you, when God's hands is on you, the devil can't do anything. He couldn't even touch Job without his permission. That's why you got to stay connected with the king. That's why you got to stay connected, because when you want your suddenly, you can't let gossip get in your ear and take you off track. Some of you been listening to the wrong things. Some of you have been listening to the wrong people. Too much chatter. Ah, that's the Holy Ghost. Too much chatter around you. Chatter will cause you to miss your elevation. There's some conversation you say, ah, excuse me. You got to put the Pentecostal finger up. So I can't get in this conversation, even though I really don't agree with it, but I got to watch my words. Because my words is what's going to elevate me. If I say the wrong words and I get in the wrong conversation, it could affect my family. Because then something could come back and say, she said, no, I didn't say that. No, you can say, she was the one to put up the Pentecostal handshake, the Pentecostal finger, and walked out. Watch your words. In this season, your words are very important. If you want to suddenly, keep your mouth shut. Speak when God tells you to speak. Sing when God tells you to sing. Sometimes you could talk too much and God said, hush, I'm trying to talk to you. going to miss my suddenly just by alcohol and drinks and different things. I can't do it this season. This is not a game that we're in. That's what Hezekiah said. They have missed God. Our ancestors have missed God. I don't want to miss God. I don't want the pomp and the circumstance. Don't give me, I said, don't just give me a platform. I want to be transformed. When you're transformed, the platform will come. I'm telling you, when you transform, the platform will come. Some of you are trying to make your way into places. My God, my God. That's what I'm talking about. Suddenly, who would know Katiti Rivera from Fox Television saying that I want her to come down here? Huh? Guess what? That's how I'm going to do it. So when my bank account gets filled, I'm going to say, God, I thank you. When your bank account gets filled, I'm going to say, glory. So you got to know what's going on in this season. That's why I told you Joanne Rosario, she's pregnant, have been trying for a long time. Then God said, you got a double blessing coming to the rock. You've got something double that's coming to this house. And if you don't see it, you might miss it, ladies and gentlemen. And God is ready to do it suddenly, even in your ministry. Some of you have things on the inside of you, businesses that you want to get, different things you want to do. I mean, God would do it. With Hezekiah, he said, God, I'm not ready to leave this earth. My God. The prophet came and said, oh, it's time for you to go. Set your house in order because death is near. Said, set your house in order. Get things in order. Isn't that something compassionate with God that God will let you know when you're getting ready to die? But he said, God, I served you. God, I gave you everything. The Bible said he turned his face to the wall. He turned his face to God. I've been serving a long time. He didn't turn his face to his Facebook. He turned his face to the wall. He didn't put it out on social media. I'm getting ready to die. He turned his face to the wall. The Bible says before the prophet got out of the room in the middle. My God, come on, we're going there tonight. I want y'all to see this. Second Kings, I think it's the 20th chapter. God help me, because somebody going to get free tonight. Because what you thought you were going to give up on your life, God said, uh-uh, not tonight. Somebody said, not tonight. Not tonight. Uh-uh. Let's go to verse 1, 21. It says, in those days was Hezekiah sick unto death. And the prophet Isaiah, the son of Amoz, came to him and said to him, thus said, set thine house in order. Somebody said, I got to set my house in order. For thou shalt die and not live. My God. Then he turned his face to the what? And prayed to the Lord. He didn't call his prayer partners. He said, I'm praying to the one that gives me strength. Going to the big man, because my friends might can help me, but he's the one to give them what to do, tell them what to do. Said, I prayed to the Lord, saying, I beseech you, O Lord, remember now how I walk before thee, my God, in truth, with a perfect heart. My God, that means my heart was complete in you, Jesus, and have done the thing which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sorely, my God, that means he's kept wept. And it came to pass, afore Hosea was gone out into the middle of the court. Somebody say, in the middle. In the middle of my struggle. In the middle of my heartache. In the middle of my challenges. My God, in the middle. In the middle. Because that's what happens in the middle. See, we're good at the beginning. We good. Oh, God, I got the job. I got the marriage. I got the child. I got this. At at the end. Oh, we're shouting victory. But it's right here in the middle. When the stinking stuff start coming. When we feel like we can't make it. When we just want to throw everything, throw the towel in. Said, I can't go that far. I don't want, it's in the middle. Somebody say, in the middle. Into the middle of the court. That what came, the word of the Lord came to him. Saying, turn again, my God. He was going this way. And God said, turn again. I got a servant that's praying. That's something when God hears your prayers. Some of you have been praying a long time. Telling the prophet, said, turn again, turn again, turn again. Hey, my God. And tell Hezekiah that the captain of my people, thus said the Lord, that the God of David, thy father, I have heard thy prayer. Jesus God. I have seen, my God, thy tears. How many have been crying in here? Isn't that something about the 180? God did a 180. He was going one way and then he went the opposite way. He said, turn again. Because I needed you to go back to my servant and tell him, the one that's been praying, the one that's been worshiping, the one that's been giving me everything, I want to change the end of this story. He thought it was the end of the story, but he had enough to open his mouth and say, God, no, not my time. God, I need to live a little bit longer. And I know who the source is. My. And it says, and heard thy prayer and seen thy tears. He said, behold, that word behold means look. I will heal thee. My God. Isn't that something that God will heal you in the midst of your sickness? Cancer can't hold up to God. Diabetes can't hold up to God. He's the healer. He said, I will heal thee on the third day. Thou shalt go up unto the house of the Lord, and I will add unto you 15 years. He didn't say, I'm going to let you live 1 year. 3 years. My God, y'all better get this tonight. He said, 15 years. I'm going to give life to you. Why do you turn your back on the ones who give you life, the one that gives you life? God healed him, even in the midst of what he was doing. Look at that. My God, 15 years. He said, and I will deliver thee in the city of the hand of the Assyria. I will defend this city for my own sake, for my servant David's sake. And it says, Isaiah said, take a lump of figs, my God. And they took and laid it on the board. And right then, that leaped in my belly, and he said, and he recovered. Somebody, I'm saying, I'm going to recover it all. See, the devil took some things away from you. The devil really took some things away from you, but just say, I'm going to recover it. Gosh, God. Woo, I'm going to recover it all. And it says, and Hezekiah said unto Isaiah, what shall be the sign that the Lord will heal me? God said, I'm going to heal you. Really do it. Should I give you a sign? But God is so generous. He's so compassionate. And that I shall go up into the house of the Lord on the third day. And Isaiah said, the sign shall that thou have of the Lord, the Lord will do the thing that he hath spoken. Oh, my God. He will do the thing that he hath spoken. What are you speaking over your situations? What have you said about your marriage? What have you said about your contract? What have you said about the writers that's supposed to write you the song? What have you said? What have you spoken? My God. Woo. Shall the shadow go forth 10 degrees or back 10 degrees? And Hezekiah answered, it is a light thing for the shadow to go down 10 degrees. Nay, but let the shadow return backwards 10 degrees. Woo! And Isaiah the prophet cried unto the Lord, and he broke the shadow, my God, 10 degrees backwards. My God, you thought it was going forward, but he said backwards. by which it had gone down the dial of Ahaz. What am I saying here? When he was supposed to die, when they was getting ready, I mean, he probably was thinking in his mind, okay, this is where my funeral is going to be. This is the coffin that I'm going to pick out. This is what I'm going to do. And God, because he prayed, because he served God. See, God, you got to understand that Hezekiah had already prepared himself. In his first month, in his first year, the first thing he did was repair the house of God. God is a note taker. So whenever you come in the house of God, when you take care of God's things, he's going to take care of you. So God didn't forget what he had done. God didn't forget how he got the Levites together. God didn't forget how they served and how they had in the house of God, how they started on the inside and worked their way on the outside. And on the 16th day, they said, we're finished. Everything is right for you, Hezekiah. It's right for the Lord to come in. That's what I'm saying. When you build your altar right, when you build your lifestyle right, when you say, for holiness, I'm going to stand. For God, I'm going to live. For God, I'm going to die. I'm telling you, God will add to your life. God will add to your bank account. God will add things to you. He's not subtracting anything from you. Hezekiah began to work in the field before. So you got to work with something. You got to ask God, say, God, I need my suddenly. I've been in this dry place a long time. I've been in this same place. I know I've been looking for Boaz for a long time. Somebody said, well, you're not going to get it. Yes, I am going to get it. What are you speaking? You say, God, I don't know how I'm going to get out of this debt. God said, I'm going to show you how to get out of debt. Well, you know, I can't pay $180. I can't pay $200. Every time these bill collectors call, you can pay $10 a week. Come on here, somebody. You can pay $5. Say, every week, God, I'm going to just pay it down. And then you see the mountain coming down. The God said, my God, the little things, the small things that they're doing, I see you. So when I bring the 100, I can't even bring, talking about bringing $100,000, I can't even bring $10 your way. God said, it's the small things. But when he does this suddenly, everybody's going to know it. Everybody's going to know it. And it's what you've been doing in your secret closet. When you get down, when you get low, go to the Father. Some of you are tossing. Some of you are turning. Some of you are moving. Some of you are just busy. And God says, stand still and see the salvation of God. I'm going to work out this situation for you. Your suddenly is right in front of you. If you let me take control. That's the thing. We don't let God take control. And he said, I've turned the thing. And who can add 15 years to your life? Only the King of Kings. Only the Lord of Lords. That's why you got to keep your doors right. You got to shine up those doors. You say, God, nothing can, everything can come in this door. Don't bring no gossip to me. Don't mess me. You can't mess me up because I got to prepare for my suddenly. I've got to prepare for the right place because while everybody's looking around and everybody's doing everything, I'm still standing here because I want my suddenly. David said, I'd rather be a doorkeeper. Just let me keep the doors and dwell in the tents of wickedness. And when you stay in the house of God's servant, you'll see suddenlies. You'll see suddenlies come. Stay in the right door. Have your doors repaired. Give to the house of God. Give when the Father tells you to give. This is a season now for your suddenly, but you got to prepare for it. Because if you don't prepare, you won't be ready for it. Uzziah was with pride. He gave him everything. And I'm ending with this. Uzziah had everything. I mean, wealth, influence, popularity, everything. Everything he had. But then he got big-headed and bust in the temple. bust in the temple and say, oh, I can do this. I can do the burnt offerings. I can do this. And the priest Azariah said, what you doing? You can't do this. You got to be the right one. You got to be the right Aaronites of the priest to do this. He looked at him like, who you talking to? I'm going to do this. He had won all those victories, but pride rose up on the inside of him. The Bible says when he held the censer in his hand, and they would say, no, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. He had done everything right in the sight of God. He listened to his pastor. He listened to his leaders. But he went and put it up there. He had the censer in his hand. They would say, no. The Bible says when he did it, that leprosy formed on his forehead. Read your Bible. Leprosy formed on his forehead. Azariah and them, they look and say, oh, no. They rushed him out of the temple. The ones that you are reluctant, they were the ones that helped him get out of there. He had leprosy all over his forehead, had good done good the whole time, didn't even mess up, but he let pride get in him. He thought he could go in the temple and do anything he wanted to. Oh, my God. Oh, I got the accolades. I got this. And God said, I'm going to show you what you have. You shouldn't have touched that. That wasn't your place. If it's not your place, stay out of it. And when he went out, my God, the Bible says he lived with leprosy and he died with leprosy. They said the people remember more of what he did not do than more of what he did do. Why do I say this? When you get into suddenly, always, when you get wealth, when you get popularity, when you get everything, always put God first. Amen. Stand to your feet. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Because the suddenlies are coming. Read your Bible. Read your Bible because it's in there. And there might be someone here tonight to say, you know what? I've backslidden. I've let wealth take me off track. I've let this popularity, I've let this influence. I just let, God, I just need to get back into the place with you. God, I'm hurting. I'm sorrowful. But I need to get back with you. And I want to introduce you to my best friend, which is Jesus. And if you say, God, I want you in my heart tonight, lift your hands right there. You can do it. You can do it. Is there anyone in here to say, God, I want you tonight. Take me. I want you in my heart. I receive you. Well, I pray that everyone has their salvation right with God. Amen. Come on, lift your hands unto the Lord. I want to pray a blessing over you tonight. Dear Heavenly Father, God, we honor you tonight. You're wonderful. You're merciful. You're grateful that we can even come into the house of God to serve you. God, we thank you that we're able to bring our Bibles in and worship you and praise you and adore you and love you. God, I thank you for these people that's in here tonight. God, they honor you. They're hungry and thirsty for you. You said those that are hungry and thirst, that those that hunger and thirst after you shall be filled with righteousness, Father God. So we thank you. Let this be the best week they ever had, God. God, I thank you, Father God, that they're not worrying about different things, Father God. But God, I thank you that the peace of God will come over. God, send the rain in their homes. Send the rain on their jobs. Send the rain on their minds, God. God, I thank you for healing this week in their hearts, Father God. And help them to move towards you, Father God. And we'd be so careful to give you the honor, praise, glory, and dominion and power belongs to you. God, we thank you. Somebody shout glory. Why don't you hug your neighbor and tell him you love him? Amen. Thank you. Have an awesome night. First time guests. We didn't have any. Okay. Amen. Hug your neighbor and tell him you love him. Thank you.
Thank you.